My name is Murat. I was at the school, believe it or not. I started in 99, Mr. Webb, with my geography teacher in year 7. 14 years ago, Mr. Williams had a lot more hair on his head. He was a really cool guy. I just want to start by saying that you all have a worksheet in front of you. You can just get something to read on. Well, why am I here today? I'm here to discuss some ideas with all of you about unleashing your potential. I'm sure this is a term that you guys have heard many times, that you have so much potential. Your teacher says it all the time, your family says it to you, you've got so much potential. You can achieve this, you can achieve that. So I'm going to discuss some ideas with you about actually achieving your own potential. Well, what have I done since I left school? In 2004, I achieved the best grades in my year. I was on the front of the newsletter with Miss Bradbury and Miss Cox. I was going to bring that picture down here today, but I just looked too funny at that, so I decided not to do that. What have I done? I went on to college, studied maths, physics, economics, and sociology. I wanted to go on to become an actuary. Why did I want to become an actuary, you might think? Well, when I was in high school, I used to love receiving letters. I never used to receive any letters. I didn't have no bills to pay. Who would ever write to me? So I signed up for this magazine about careers. And it opened this magazine one day, and it said, the most money that you can make if you go to uni is if you become an actuary. You qualify and you make it over £100,000 a year. And I thought, wow, that's amazing. £100,000 a year, if I just go to university, get a degree, and I'm making a lot of money, my life's made. So, got the grades that I wanted to get. I had worked on my personal statement, as Mr. Webb was talking about. There was some ideas I'll discuss with you about, some ideas you could add to that. So I got into my first choice of university. I was at City studying actuarial science. And I was in my second year, and my dad passed away. And it just completely knocked the wind out of me, and I really thought that this was the end for me. I didn't have the support that many of my friends had, many of the people I was studying with. I didn't have that same level of support, so I thought, maybe I will never achieve my potential. I left university in my second year, started to work, and I was in the real world. And in the real world, it's not like when you're in school, when your teachers run around after you and say, have you done your work, have you done this, have you done that? In the real world, no one wakes you up when you need to go to work in the morning. It doesn't work like that. And I wanted to make £100,000 a year. And if I was sitting on 20,000, 25,000, working my way up, and I thought, I will never get to 100 if I carry on like this. And so what happened was, carried on working, and I got a job in a prison, as a prison officer, maximum security prison, working with some of the most notorious criminals that this country has to offer. And it was there that I first came across one lady who said to me, she said, when I was 8 years old, I used to steal from the shops, I used to steal from the supermarket. My first reaction was, oh, what kind of things did your parents teach you that you were stealing when you were that old? And she said to me, if I didn't steal, I wouldn't eat dinner. Now, that really shocked me, that I was 8 years old once and I was playing around in the park and watching kids' shows on TV. I had food in the fridge. I was lucky. I had a family that cared. I had a good support network that. Why was I in the situation that I was not able to unleash my own potential? So, carried on. And it was only until a year ago that I really thought I'm going to challenge myself, that this is my opportunity to succeed, and if I'm going to do something with my life, I'm going to do it now. So the last year, I've invested in a franchise. I've started my own company called Modifier, qualified personal trainer and life coach. I've got my own gym, all within 1 year, because I have unleashed my potential. And there's really nothing that can slow me down. And there are some ideas that I will discuss with you that I really hope you can take something away with and help to unleash your own potential. Another thing that I did in the last year, and touching on what Mr. Webb was talking about, your personal statement, I've done a lot of work for charity. I've raised over £5,000 for charity. I'm in the process of registering my own charity now called the Modified World. And what inspired me to start doing some charity work was this orphanage that I've heard about in Jalandhar in Punjab. I'm sure there's a lot of people that know about that area. And how this place works is, they have a cot outside an orphanage, and for families that don't want to have girls in Punjab, if you have too many girls, it can be expensive, or some people can't look after the children. So what they do is, there's a cot outside this orphanage, and what families do is they go and put the newborn baby girls inside this cot after midnight, and after 2 minutes, an alarm goes off. The weight of the baby sets off an alarm, and these ladies come out from the orphanage, they pick these girls up, who they don't know where they come from, who they are, they give them names, they look after them, they educate them. Some of them are taken from when they're just 3 days old, and now they're in their 20s, and they're working in the orphanage. The lady that started off this orphanage was an orphan herself. That to me is very inspiring, that people that have nothing can still make it very far. They can achieve their goals, and I'm sure all of you here are more fortunate than those people that are out there. Okay, moving on now. Shoot for the moon. Even if you miss, you will land among the stars. It might sound far-fetched, shoot for the moon. Okay, but what this actually means to me is that if you challenge yourself and you set yourself some very, very high goals, you will do everything you can to achieve them, and even if you don't, you will be very close. What is performance? Okay, we all watched the Olympics this year. We were very fortunate to have them in London. Performance, if we were to look at an athlete, they all have personal bests. If they break that record of their personal best, they have put in a very good performance. The same way, if you guys have predicted grades, that if you're predicted a B and you get an A, you put in a good performance. Okay? So performance, results and outcomes. That is how we measure it. And performance is what separates possessing knowledge to using knowledge. And I'm sure all you guys, when you get to your exam, you think, oh, I know this, I've done this, but the exams are what test you. And that's what will measure your performance, are the results and outcomes. Okay, so now we're gonna start using the sheet now. In question one, you have a question about writing your goals, about what you want to achieve by the end of this academic year. I want you all to really think about this now. Really think about what it is that you want to achieve by the end of this year. Now we're going to talk about potential. Potential is something that is very, 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 very powerful. Potential, what I used to be when I used to sit down, like you guys are now, sitting in assemblies, we used to have our teachers talking, we used to have guest speakers, and I'd be sitting there thinking, okay, how is this going to help me? I know everything. How is this going to help me? But potential, let me tell you something now, this is a variable. This changes every single day. Every day that I wake up, my goal is to add to my potential. And it's the same way that you guys can continue to add to your potential. So we're going to have a look at a couple of things about what is potential, knowledge, skills, commitment, experience, education. And one of the greatest things about potential is determination. How determined are you to unleash your potential? That is a very powerful question. So right now, I want you all to take a look at this list, and in question two, I want you to write down 2 things that you can do to increase your potential. What is interference? Now, I'm sure many of you guys might use stuff like Facebook, Twitter, you want to go home, you might watch some TV, you're on the phone, your friends. All this kind of stuff, in some way that you may look at it, is interference. Why is it interference? Because it's slowing you down. If something is slowing you down, it's allowing you to stay distracted, you will see that as interference. There's a couple of other things that we're going to have a look at, what interference is. Low motivation. Low confidence. Anxiety. Stress. Lacking focus. And another one that's very powerful for me as a life coach, limiting beliefs. I'm just going to talk about limiting beliefs for a moment. If we were to use an example of you guys having some exams now, you've got some more exams coming in June, and you think to yourself, I can't get an A. It's not possible. So So now all your actions up until you have your exams are going to be geared towards not achieving the A that you want. Maybe it's a B, C, whatever it is for yourself. If you limit yourself before you start, you are actually limiting your actions. So what I want you to do now in question three, by having a look at this list and a couple of ideas we spoke about, I want you to write down two things that you can do to eliminate interference in your life. Now we move on to the magic. This equation to me is magic. It's the most influential equation I've ever come across, and I've loved maths my whole life. When I came across this equation, it just blew my mind. Your performance, your results or outcomes, are equal to your potential minus your interference. Slow you down, your performance could be equal to your potential. So if you look at all the things that you have written down in number three, if you were to reduce those, everyone look down at your sheets, all the things that you've written down in number two, if you were to add to those, you would achieve the things that you have written down in number one. By eliminating your interference, performance equals potential. Next thing, this is just one slide, almost done now. You'll be able to use this information in all your future exams. When that fact, anything that you do in the future, you will come across the cycle of change. That myself, the teachers, even yourselves, if you look back at anything that you've done in the past, you'll be able to apply it to this cycle. It all begins with pre-confrontation. You might think, oh, well, exams coming up in June. You don't think about it too much until you get to the next stage, confrontation. You think, okay, I really need to stop planning now. If I stop putting some work in 2 hours a day, you know, I will be able to get the A that I want. Get to the next stage, the most important stage of any plan is action. In your exams thinking, I wish I had put in more action. And those of you who ace your exams, you'll walk out and think that was easy because you put in the time. And when your exams are over, it comes to the end of the cycle, realize. Now you might think, like, why is this important? Because the next time that you come back into this now, you have experience and knowledge. So when you go back to pre-confrontation again, you'll think, oh, I've done this before. In question four, I would like you to write down what actions will take you closer to achieving your goal. So this is your opportunity. You must maximize your opportunity to succeed. And I'm going to ask you, and you can only be honest with yourself when you're answering this question, what would you feel if your goal never came true? So having a look through the slides that you've been through, listening to myself speak and the things that you've written down, how committed are you to achieve your goal? I just want to wish you luck for your exams and your times ahead. I know that everyone will be applying to uni in the next 6 months to a year or so. And really, really try your best to unleash your potential now. And thank you for listening.